Okay, let's start. Hello, welcome to our Biostatistics and Epidemiology Sessions 15 to 16. For today's lecture, we'll cover the topics for your hypothesis testing and kinds of statistical tests. This is just a quick reminder to everyone that the areas under the normal curve, the problem solving on your module, will be discussed in another lecture video. Again, a quick reminder to everyone that areas under the normal curve and the problem solving on your module will be discussed in another lecture video. Okay, let's start. These are your learning outcomes. Upon the completion of this lesson, the MLS student can (1) define the hypothesis and hypothesis testing, identify the two types of hypotheses, (3) apply the level of significance in statistical data, (4) explain the importance of setting the level of significance, (5) indicate how the normal distribution can be used to calculate probabilities, (6) determine the areas of region under the normal curve, and lastly, relate and convert z-scores to standard scores. So, parati nating may encounter itong ating normal curve. So, dapat i-familiarize na natin yung sarili natin as early as now. Yung naka-red is the region of rejection or your rejection region. And then yung naka-blue, color blue, is the area of acceptance. And then these are the symbols applicable for our biostatistics. HO or your H subscript O stands for your null hypothesis. H1 or your HA stands for your alternative hypothesis. B or your the Greek letter beta, which is the probability of committing a type 2 error. Greek letter alpha, which denotes a probability of committing a type 1 error and is known as the level of significance. Next, Greek letter sigma, which means the variance. Next, the standard deviation of the sampling distribution of the mean. Next, yung very familiar na tayo na Greek letter mu, which is the mean of the normal population mean. Next, yung small n, sample size. And then t-distribution, a case where the population standard deviation is unknown. And lastly, yung small s natin is your standard deviation. Okay, what is hypothesis? What is a hypothesis? A hypothesis is an assumption about the population parameter. A parameter is a population mean or proportion. And then the parameter must be identified before the analysis. A hypothesis daw is an intelligent guess. It is an intelligent guess or an assumption. And then when we say hypothesis, we have two types. It can be expressed in a sentence form or in a question form, just like on this one. I assume that the mean GPA of this class is 3.5. And then here are the other examples of your hypothesis. Is the proportion of SJC's male students' weight are significantly higher than SJC's female students? Does the mean height of senior school high school differs from the junior high school students? So yun yung mga examples natin ng ating hypothesis. Yung sentence form na inassume niya. And then meron siyang dalawang question dito na hypothesis pa rin. Next, the theory of statistical inference consists of methods which one makes inferences or generalizations about a population. Example is the test of hypothesis. So, na-define na natin sa ating introduction to biostatistics and two types of test noon, yung descriptive statistics and your inferential statistics. Kapag ka-inferential statistics, gumagamit tayo ng hypothesis testing or yung generalization natin. Okay, next. These are the steps in hypothesis testing. We only have 7, so we have to memorize this by heart. And then, we have to fully understand the concepts underlying these following steps. (1) step is the stating the null and alternative hypothesis. Statistical hypothesis, it is a statement about the value of a parameter, your population mean, median mode and standard deviation, proportion, and etc. An assertion or proposition about the relationship between two or more variables. And when we say hypothesis, statistical hypothesis, we have two forms, which is our null hypothesis and our alternative hypothesis. And then these are the elements of a test of a hypothesis. Yung null hypothesis natin or yung HO, it shows no significance difference, no changes, nothing happened, no relationship between two parameters. So, pwede natin siyang i-express katulad nito. HO is equals to the mean of variable 1 is equals to no significant difference is equals to the mean of variable number 2. Meanwhile, for your alternative hypothesis or yung H1 mo or HA, it shows significant difference, an effect, change, and relationship between the parameter and the specific value. Yung null and alternative hypothesis pa rin natin. Null hypothesis is the hypothesis of no difference. It is often used to signify the equivalence of a parameter to a specified value or the similarity between groups. And then, null hypothesis, ulit-ulit, it is the statement of equality. Wala nga dong pinagkaiba. No difference, equal. So, ang symbol na gagamitin natin doon, syempre equal. Kapag ka-alternative hypothesis naman, ito daw yung research hypothesis. The hypothesis that the investigator believes in. It is either non-directional, yung two-tailed test, and then the directional, yung one-tailed. Kung kay null hypothesis, equal sila, equal, kabaligtaran naman kay alternative, not equal. So, yung equal, lagyan mo lang ng slash, not equal. Pag kay non-directional, pag directional naman, pwedeng less than, pwedeng greater than. So, elaborate na lang natin siya on our next slides. Okay, null hypothesis, when you encounter these keywords, meron ka ng idea na isa siyang null hypothesis. Equal to, the same as, not change from, and then yung very familiar na is, very popular. Next, alternative naman yung HA or H1 mo. Pag two-tailed test, yung non-directional, walang papupuntahan. Non-directional, not equal, different from, change from, not the same as. Ito yung mga keywords natin. Kapag ka-directional, one-tailed test, greater than, above, higher than, longer than, bigger than, increased, at least. And then less than, below, lower than, smaller than, shorter than, decreased or reduced from, and then yung at most. Types of alternative hypotheses, yung elaborate natin yung non-directional mo and then your directional. Non-directional, it is a two-tailed test. It simply states that the true value of the parameter is not equal to hypothesized value. And then there is a difference in the groups being compared. Ito siya. Kapag ka-directional na one-tailed test, it specifies direction of disagreement with your HO. And then the true value is higher than hypothesized value, pwedeng higher than, or the true value is less than the hypothesized value. And is expressed on this way. So, meron tayong example in stating your null and alternative hypotheses. Suppose a proposed study was used to compare the performance in anatomy of two groups of students, those using cadavers for demonstration, yung mga gumagamit doon ng cadaver, and then those using models. Yung mga models na makikita natin sa laboratory, yung mga skeletal system, yung mga muscular system na models natin, so pinagko-compare daw yun, yung mga students na gumagamit nitong two types of models. If the parameter for evaluating students' performance is the proportion who obtain a grade of 2.0 or better, how do we write our HO and HA? For your null hypothesis, state natin siya katulad nito, HO is equals to the proportion of those who are using model. Gamitan na lang natin ang initial na M for model, C for cadaver. Proportion of those who are using the model is equals to or no, there's no difference between the proportion of those who are using cadaver. So, pag in-state naman natin siya in a sentence form, the proportion of students who obtain a grade of 2.0 or better among those using models for demonstration, PM, is equal to the proportion among those using cadavers, PC. Again, no difference, equality, HO. Null hypothesis ang equal. Meanwhile, for your alternative hypothesis, pwede natin siyang i-express in a two-tailed test or your one-tailed test. HA, PM is not equal to PC. Pag gagawin naman natin siyang in a sentence form, the proportion of students who obtain a grade of 2.0 or better among those using models for demonstration, PM is not equal to the proportion among those using cadavers, yung PC mo. Pag i-express naman natin siya sa one-tailed test, HA, PM is greater than PC. The proportion of students who obtain a grade of 2.0 or better among those using models for demonstration, PM, is greater than the proportion among those using cadavers. Likewise, pwede din naman natin gamit yung less than, di ba? PM is less than the proportion among those using cadavers. And then, meron tayong mga few examples for our alternative hypothesis. I-express natin siya isa notation, parang ganyan. And then, basahin ko lang siya and then I'll give you a few minutes to answer this. Pwede nyo siyang gawing exercise para maging ma-practice na kayo on notating or expressing your hypothesis. Okay, let me just read this. The mean length of stay of patients in Hospital C is not equal to 3 days. Next, the mean length of stay of patients in Ward A is longer than those in Ward B. Next, the percentage of fully immunized children in Barangay Z is less than 85%. And then the percentage of fully immunized children in Sitio X and the percentage of fully immunized in Sitio Y are different. So, kung makikita mo sa mga keywords, meron ka na talagang idea na alternative hypothesis siya. So, i-express mo na siya sa notation. Ito na siya. The mean length, so ginamit niya yung mu, is not equal yung ginamit na symbol, to 3 days. So, what do we infer from that? It is a two-tailed test. Next, the mean length of stay of patients in Ward A, gamitin na lang natin initial si A or WA, mean WA, pwede naman, wala naman problema, is longer than or greater than the stay of those who are in Ward B, mean of B. And then, what do we infer from that? It is a one-tailed test. Next, the percentage daw is less than 85%. Is less than. So, it is a one-tailed test. And then next, the percentage of Sitio X, pwede namang SX, Sitio X is not equal to or are different from those who are in Sitio Y. Okay, again, it is a two-tailed test. Sa statement pa lang or sa sentence pa lang, makikita mo na talaga siya if it is a null or alternative hypothesis based pa lang dun sa keywords. Okay? Again, walang katapusan na example. You have to test yourself. State the null and alternative hypothesis for each statement. A medical trial is conducted to test whether or not a new medicine reduces uric acid by 50%. If you're going to express it in your null hypothesis, the new medicine can reduce uric acid. And then the alternative, the new medicine cannot reduce uric acid. Next, we want to test whether the general average of students in math is different from 80%. HO, the general average of students in math is equals to 80%. HA naman yan, is the general average of students in math is different from 80%. And then last example, we want to test whether the mean height of grade 8 students is 58 inches. So kung i-state mo siya sa iyong HO na mean height of students is 58 inches, is, di ba, keyword for null hypothesis. And then the mean height of students is not 58 inches. Kapag two-tailed, pwede mo rin naman siyang i-express sa one-tailed test, pwede mong gamitan ng less than or higher than. And then the hypothesis testing, a set of procedures that culminates in either the rejection or non-rejection of a hypothesis. So kung magkakanda ka na ng study mo or ng research mo, gagawa ka muna ng HO versus HA. Mag-formulate ka muna ng iyong null and alternative hypothesis. After that, you're going to collect the data from your sample. And then after analyzing and after processing your data collected, do your findings support your HO? If your answer is yes, you do not reject your HO. And then if ang answer mo after processing your data, if no ang sagot mo, you will reject your HO. Okay? Next, the non-rejection of HO. Instead of accepting HO, it is more accurate to say that the researcher fails to reject HO. Again, naka-bold letter siya. Instead of saying na accept the HO, the researcher fails to reject HO. Ito yung sasabihin natin, yung state natin yan. Because there is no proof or not a proof that the null hypothesis is correct. And then, insufficient proof to conclude that your alternative hypothesis rather than a proof of your null hypothesis. Again, these are the factors that may contribute to non-rejection, the inadequacy of sample size, and then the measurement problems. So, very important na valid yung mga measurement na gagamitin natin and then tama yung pagkuha natin ng sample size. So, your study wouldn't put into waste. Again, to formulate your alternative and your null hypothesis, ito siya, ina-express ang one-tailed test mo, sa isa ka lang mag-shade, so elaborate na lang natin yan sa kasunod. And then yung pag two-tailed test, dalawa yung shade mo, dalawang end sa tail, dalawang tail, di ba? Two-tailed ka. Dun sa end part, dalawa yung shade mo. So elaborate na lang natin yan later on. Walang kamatayang example kasi nga gustong-gusto po ng mga second year students of St. Jude College, Manila na maraming example binibigay si ma'am. So ito na po siya. The school register believes that the average number of enrolls this school year is not the same as the previous school year. So kung i-express mo siya sa iyong null hypothesis, HO average or yung mean mo is equals to ganito. And then yung alternative mo. And then kapag ka naman daw ang alternative mo ay gumamit ng not equal to, it is a two-tail test. So therefore, ang isi-shade mong tail ay dalawang side. Kasi nga symmetrical sila. Pag hinati mo sa gitna, symmetrical sila. So kung isi-shade mo yung kabila, isi-shade mo rin yung kabila if only it is a two-tail test. And then however, if the school register believes that the average number of enrollees this school year is less than the previous school year, then you will have this. So, ginamit mo ng less than. Use the left-tailed when alternative hypothesis contains the symbol less than. So, pag less than, ang isi-shade mong part yung left. Kapag ka naman right-tailed or yung greater than mo, ang isi-shade mo yung right part. So, kung paano tayo mag-shade, anong naging basis natin kung bakit isi-shade mo yung ganitong part, i-discuss natin yan later on. Pero meron na kayong overview on where to shade. Left kapag ka less than, right kapag ka greater than. And then if it's a two-tailed test, you will shade both sides. So sa lahat ng mga sinabi kong yon, nasa stating the null and alternative hypothesis pa lang tayo. So moving on to stating the level of significance, your step number 2, the level of significance. Let me just read this. Significance is defined as the quality of being statistically significant. Level of significance, it is denoted by alpha or A. Yung small a refers to the degree of significance in which we accept or reject the null hypothesis. 100% accuracy is not possible in accepting or rejecting a hypothesis. The significance level is also the probability of making the wrong decision when the null hypothesis is true. And then nabanggit ko na noon na in public health research, alpha is usually 0.01 if we want to test the efficacy of a drug or kapag ka merong involved na buhay ng pasyente, we usually set the alpha to 0.01 with 1% or the 99% confidence level. Meanwhile, if it's only a social science, pwede naman natin iset ang ating alpha to 0.05 or yung 5%. With 95% confidence level, and then 0.10 or 10% in other studies naman. And then this implies that there is 1%, 5%, or 10% probability of rejecting a true null hypothesis. Okay, nakapula. So, ibig sabihin, importante. Again, the researcher sets the level of significance arbitrarily. These are the important concepts and terms for your hypothesis testing. The level of significance or yung small a, it is the probability of committing a type 1 error. Usually, it is set at 0.05, 0.10, or 0.01. The probability level that is considered too low to warrant support of the hypothesis being tested. And lastly, the lower the level of the significance, the more the data must diverge from the null hypothesis to be significant. A 0.01 level is more conservative than a 0.05 level. Bakit? Kasi nga dito, 99% confidence level ka. Dito naman, 95% ka. So, mas conservative talaga si 0.01. And then, these are the errors in hypothesis testing. Based on your statistical decision based on sample data, we have 2. Reject the HO and do not reject the HO. And then, true state of affairs in the population, HO is true. HO is not true. Kapag ka nireject mo yung HO mo, pero totoo yung null hypothesis mo, you will commit a type 1 error. Meanwhile, kapag ka naman nireject mo yung HO mo, pero yung HO mo is not true, nireject mo tapos hindi true, I made the correct decision. This is very comparable to a real life situation wherein, let's say, isa kang judge. And then, meron isang napagbintangan or si, let's say, si Mark. Example lang ha, baka may student tayong Mark. Si Mark ay nasa isang trial for a rape case. And then, Mark did not commit the rape. Diba? Hindi naman talaga rapist si Mark. He was in other place or depende kung anong talagang totoong dahilan. Pero ang totoo, we all know na hindi naman talaga rapist si Mark. Pero as a judge, naipakulong mo siya. Na-acquaint mo siya as guilty. So, comparing to our biostatistics, you've committed a type 1 error. Na inosente si Mark pero naipakulong mo siya as a judge. Okay? Text naman natin, if you do not reject your HO and then your HO is true, you made the correct decision. And then, hindi mo na nga nireject yung HO mo pero hindi pala totoo yung HO mo. Hindi mo nireject pero hindi mo, HO is not true, you will most likely to commit a type 2 error or yung beta error mo. So, comparing to your real life situation, isa kang judge and then meron si Joshua, sana wala tayong Joshua na student dito. Merong Joshua na siya naman talaga yung rapist, he is really the one who committed the rape. And then napalaya mo siya. Dun sa trial or siguro dalawa silang pinagbintangan, si Mark lang yung napakulong na inosente, si Joshua na talagang nag-commit ng rape, napalaya mo. It is very comparable to your type 2 error or yung beta mo. Okay, gets? Siya talaga yung acquainted, siya talaga yung nag-commit ng rape, pero napalaya mo siya. Okay? Alpha must be low when it is important not to reject a true HO. Beta must be low if it is important not to reject a false HO. Okay, medyo nakakalito lang siya basahin. Reject, HO is true, type 1 error. Pero pag inintindi mo siya, kahit basahin mo siya ng 10 times, alam mo siya. Okay? Next step is the selecting the appropriate test statistic. We're done with stating the null and alternative hypothesis. Next, we're done with stating the level of significance. Next on our step is selecting the appropriate test statistic. In selecting the appropriate statistic, test criterion or test statistic depends on the sampling distribution of the sample statistic which is used to the hypothesis. And then these are the criteria for test selection. We have the objectives of the study, the design of the study, the types of variables, the level of measurement, whether the samples are related or independent, and then the assumption about the test. Meron tayong available na iba't ibang test on which we will discuss sa ating pinaka-period 3. Hindi basta-basta tayo mamimili lang dito. Ay, gusto ko sa study ko si Z-test. Ay, bet ko to kasi parang ang ganda one-way ANOVA. Ay, ang ganda pakinggan ni McNemar's test. Hindi po ganun. Meron po tayong test criterion based on your objectives, on the design of the study, the types of variable, and then etc. So, just to give you a quick overview on what we're going to tackle on our period 3, ito po siya. The types of data depende doon. Nakadepende siya doon. And then, if it's one sample, if it's two unpaired sample, ayan, i-elaborate na lang natin on our period 3 proper. Pero ito, hypothesis testing pa lang and then kinds of statistical test pa lang ang ating babanggitin dito. And then, ito pa rin sila. Mga binomial test, Rounds test, Kolmogorov test. Okay, marginal, McNemar. Paired t-test. Okay? Ayan. Next, after selecting the appropriate test statistic, next naman natin is determining the critical region. How to use the critical region? Determine whether your alternative hypothesis implies a one-tailed or two-tailed test. Determine the value of the test statistic corresponding to the set alpha. This will give you the divide between the critical region, which is your rejection region, and then the non-rejection region. reject the null hypothesis if computed test statistic falls at a region of rejection. And then do not reject the null hypothesis if computed test statistic falls at a non-rejection region. Excuse me. Okay, going back. Ito na nga yung sinasabi natin kanina pa on how to use your critical region. Dito na natin malalaman kung sa alternative hypothesis mo, syempre dapat alam mo muna yung one, if it's one-tailed or two-tailed. Diba? Tapos saka natin siya ipa-plot sa normal curve. And then after, asan na nga ba yun? After computing, diba, reject the null hypothesis kasi itong mga binigay nating mga test na yan, meron silang mga formula din. And then after computation naman, if the test statistic daw falls at a region of rejection, reject the null hypothesis if computed test statistic falls at the region of rejection. And then do not reject your null hypothesis if computed test statistics falls at non-rejection region. Alin ba yung non-rejection region? Area of rejection, non-area of rejection. Na, tama ba? Non-rejection region, rather. Okay? Where are we? And then these are the commonly used of level of significance and its corresponding critical values. Ma-familiarize muna kayo dito. And then di-discuss natin yan further on our next few slides. These are the important concepts and terms of hypothesis testing, tackling your critical region. It is the area under the curve where the computed test statistic falls. There is a basis to reject HO. Okay, normal curve. Non-rejection region. O, di ba pupunta pa ako sa dating slides? Meron naman palang example dito. Anyway, ito yung non-rejection region natin. Anong type of test to? It is a two-tailed test kasi dalawa yung shaded part natin sa tail. And then yung critical region natin, ito siya. Okay? And then the p-value is the probability of obtaining a result as extreme as or more extreme than the value observed from the sample given that the null hypothesis is true. It is the number that tells us how unusual our sample results are given that HO is true. The value of which can be used as a basis for rejecting HO. So, yung computation mo daw dito, kasama yung mga test mo, kapag na-compute mo na siya, pag less than siya sa alpha mo, that will be the time that you will reject your HO. Again, if yung p-value mo, yung na-compute mong p-value is less than your alpha, you will reject your HO. Okay? These are the testing for statistical significance. Ma'am, nakakalito, ano ba yung alpha? Ano ba yung p-value or your probability value? Significance level o yung alpha mo, it is the level in which we are allowed to reject null hypothesis. And then yung probability mo or yung p-value mo, it is the likelihood of an observed statistic occurring on the basis of sampling distribution. Again, who decides the level? The researcher. If p-value is less than the alpha, reject the null hypothesis. Therefore, your study is statistically significant. Meanwhile, if your p-value is greater than the alpha, you fail to reject your null hypothesis, and then you will therefore say that your study is statistically non-significant. Okay, huwag na malilito sa significance level and then sa probability value or your p-value. Next. Ito pa rin mga important concepts and terms on your hypothesis testing is the confidence level or yung alpha. It is the probability of not committing a type 1 error depending on the set data. The confidence level may be 90.95 or yung 99. Pag kinonvert mo siya sa percentage, 90%, 95%, 99%. Ito naka-decimal point lang. And then the power 1b is the probability of not committing a type 2 error. Usually it is set between 0.70 and 0.90. On your scenario 1, the HO is the mean or the average is not equals to 3. kapag in-express natin siya sa ating alternative hypothesis, the mean or the average is greater than 3. So, i-plot natin siya under our normal curve. Itong blue na to, after doing the test statistics, kapag na-compute mo na siya, yung blue na to ay lumabas yung p-value ko 0.03. And then yung alpha ko 0.05. Nag-fall ba siya sa loob ng alpha mo, yung p-value mo? Oo, so reject mo yung HO. Okay, asa na yun? Reject, ito yung statement ha, balikan lang natin. Reject the null hypothesis if computed test statistic falls at region of rejection. So after doing your statistical test, napagtanto mo, ito kasi yung alpha, sineset mo na yan, una pa lang. Alpha, sinet mo na bago mo paggawin yung study mo. I mean, yung ginawa mo yung study mo bago mo pa makolect yung data mo, bago mo pa i-process yun, bago mo pa i-analyze, and then i-compute mo, iset mo na yung alpha mo or yung confidence level mo. Kasi kapag sinet mo siya nung towards the latter part na ng study mo, may chance na pwede mo na siyang baguhin, baka dayain mo, ay, para lang maging significant yung study ko, sige, iset ko na lang ng 0.0 ganito, 0.03, 0.02. So, yung alpha mo, una pa lang, siniset mo na siya. Yung confidence level, yung alpha mo, iset mo na. Sa study mo pa lang, malaman mo pa lang kung ano yung study na gagawin mo, iset mo na yung alpha mo para hindi ka magkaroon ng bias na papalitan mo siya sa huli. Sa una pa lang, iset mo na. So, ang sabi daw doon, if the, ano ulit yung statement niya? Reject the null hypothesis if the computed test statistic falls at the region of rejection. Did it fall? Under? Yes. So, we have to reject our HO. Scenario number 2 stating that the HO, the average, is equal to 3. Express it in an alternative hypothesis. The average is not equal to 3. And then, if pinlot mo siya sa isang normal curve, ito yung area of acceptance, non-rejection region rather. And then, if it's a two-tailed test, tapos nag-fall siya dito, nung na-compute mo na, hindi na siya sa region, area of rejection, hindi siya nag-fall under doon. And then, you do not reject your HO. Okay, gets? Eh, paano naman po, ma'am, kapag if it's a one-tailed test? Again, your HO, the mean is equal to 3. Express it in a HA. So, yun ang example natin. Less than, the average is less than 3. If pinlot mo siya dyan, ang alpha mo 0.05, pero na-compute mo, yung pagkaka-compute mo, nandito siya, you do not reject your HO. Okay? Meron din pala tayong ginagamit na table kapag kapinlot natin to, ha, which we will further elaborate on our areas under the normal curve lecture. So, kung paano siya ipa-plot, doon ko ituturo yun kung paano. Again, the 4-1-tailed test or directional test, the critical region is at the left of the acceptance region. Kanina pa natin yung paulit-ulit. And then, 4-1-tailed test or directional test, the greater than, the critical region is at the right side of the acceptance region. And then, for 2-tailed test or non-directional test, the critical region is at the left and right sides of the acceptance region. Next, we're done with determining the critical region. We will now compute the test statistic. We have to take note that we have a value of the test statistic which divides the distribution into a rejection and non-rejection region. In this step, we are not referring to that, but instead, on the test statistic that would be computed from your data, which is your observed statistic. Ito yung formula niya. Test statistic is equal to observed statistic minus expected parameter under null divided by the standard error. So, elaborate na lang talaga natin siya on our period 3 proper, which we will discuss those following tests na na-mention natin. And then next, make a statistical decision. The statistical decision is always towards the null hypothesis, whether we reject or do not reject. Ways to make a statistical decision, including this 3, looking at where the computed test statistic falls. Does it fall in the rejection region? Assessing whether the corresponding p-value is less than alpha or not. and then look at the confidence interval estimates. And then if that's a statistical, if that statistical decisions, if computed test statistic falls under the region of rejection, and then the null hypothesis is rejected. Okay, pansin nyo yung mga slides ni ma'am paulit-ulit para ma-retain nyo sa inyo at ma-convert nyo siya into a long-term memory. So, habang nag-discuss tayo dito, nagsasagot din tayo, talagang mahahasa na tayo on our hypothesis testing. And then, if otherwise, the null hypothesis is not rejected. If the p-value is less than the alpha, the null hypothesis is rejected. And then, if the p-value, yung na-compute mong p-value, is greater than the alpha, the null hypothesis is not rejected. So, ito siya. Parang ganyan lang din yung mga examples natin kanina. And then lastly, the last step on your steps in hypothesis testing, gagawa ka na ng conclusion mo. So, yun naman talaga yung purpose mo in doing or conducting your study. For you to come up with the conclusion, ma-implement siya, and then you will make an impact. An outcome muna pala. An outcome, and then you will make an impact. Or the long-term health program, diba? Yung pang long term. That is the main reason on why you did your study for you to come up with the best conclusion. Okay? Rejection of the null hypothesis leads to a conclusion stating this way. So, after nung mga pinagagagawa natin, ito pa, ganito mo siya i-state. There is a sufficient evidence to say that and then state mo yung alternative hypothesis mo. Kapag ka naman non-rejection of the null hypothesis leads to a conclusion stated this way, there is no sufficient evidence to say that, state mo yung alternative hypothesis mo. So, yung mga sinasabi kong to, yung parang kung i-relate natin siya sa isang real-life setting, yung parang guilty or not guilty. Kapag ka, di ba, nagpataw yung isang judge, Mark is not guilty for committing the rape or the crime, not guilty yung in-state doon. Hindi sinabing, Mark is innocent of committing the crime. Kasi nga, hindi mo naman, wala ka namang sufficient evidence to say that he was guilty. But rather, you have the sufficient evidence to say that he was not guilty. Magkaiba yun. He's not guilty, he's innocent. Stated siya in a different way. Magkaiba silang dalawa. Okay, gets? So, balikan lang natin lahat ng mga pinagagawa natin kanina. In a nutshell lang, mabilisan lang to. Hypothesis testing, example, state your null and alternative hypothesis. Example, the director of Hospital J wants to know if on the average patients are admitted for more than 3 days in the hospital. Okay, paano mo i-state yung null hypothesis mo? Kapag gagawin mo siyang statement, the mean length of patient stay is equals to 3 days. So, i-express na natin siya, HO is equals to, the mean is equals to 3 days. Okay, try natin siyang pag-practicean. That pala, hindi ko ni-reveal yung sagot para try yung sagutan. Anyway, alternative hypothesis, the mean length of patient stay is more than 3 days. Okay, on your own, try niyo siyang gawan ng notation. Express na siya yung alternative hypothesis natin. I'll give you a few minutes and then you can now, pwede niyo siyang i-pause and then proceed na kayo dun sa susunod nating example. Okay? Next, set the level of significance. By specifying the level of significance, the researcher sets up the rejection and non-rejection of HO. It is important to decide on level of significance early on this process to avoid manipulation. Again, yun yung mga sinabi ni Ma'am kanina. Iset mo na nga naman yung level of significance mo nung una pa lang. Para hindi mo siya ma-manipulate as a researcher kapag kapapunta ka na sa dulo ng conclusion mo. Para lang masabi na significant yung study mo. For example, you want to know the hospital stay, katulad nga nito, yung average hospital stay if you're a hospital director. And then, hindi mo sinet yung level of significance mo una pa lang nun study. So, at the end, gusto mong i-manipulate para nga naman mapaikli yung hospital stay ng mga pasyente. Kasi nga, ang sabi nila, mas maikli yung panahon na nagsistay yung pasyente sa hospital, mas kumikita yung hospital. Anyway, that's for another discussion. But, iyon yung conclusion. Na mas hindi siya hypothesis lang. It is proven naman na mas matagal, mas maikli yung ini-stay ng pasyente sa hospital. Mas kumikita yung hospital. So as a hospital director, gusto mo 'yun, 'di ba? So para mo lang mag hindi mo siya ma-manipulate, dapat una pa lang iset mo na yung level of significance mo. It is important to decide on level of significance early on this process to avoid manipulation. After the test statistic has been computed to obtain desired outcome, you may choose from 0.05, 0.10, or 0.01. Next, test statistic. In selecting the test statistic, you have to consider these following factors: the objectives of the study, the design of the study, the types of variables, the level of measurement, whether the samples are related or independent, and then the assumption about the test if it's parametric or non-parametric. Next is determining your critical region, if it's one-tailed or two-tailed, depending on your alternative hypothesis. For example, two-tailed test, z-test with a zero alpha of 0.05. So, di ko ata na-mention kanina na if it's two-tailed test and then ang alpha mo 0.05, hahatiin mo 0.025 sa kabila, 0.025 sa kabila kasi nga symmetrical sila, hinatiin mo sa gitna, the other one reflects the other one. So, hindi pwedeng 0.05 dito, 0.05 dito. 0.05 siya as a whole. So, divide mo na lang silang dalawa. Okay? And then the computation from the data contained in the sample where we compute a value of the test statistic and compare it with the rejection and non-rejection regions that have already been specified. The basic formula of a test statistic is that test statistic is equals to observed statistic minus expected parameter divided by the standard error of the observed statistic. And then your statistical decision, it is to compare test statistic with the critical region. If the computed value falls under the critical region, then we reject our HO. Uy, kabisado na nila, kanina pa binanggit ni ma'am na mga 3 times na ata. If the computed value falls under the critical region, we have to reject our HO. And then otherwise, we cannot reject our HO. Example, computed test statistic Z is equals to 2.12. Okay, 2.12 is greater than 1.96. And then, we reject our HO. Another example in your statistical decision is you can compare with the p-value with alpha. Statistical software will automatically give the p-value. So, yung ginagawa natin dito, mano-mano to. Pero ngayon, masyado na tayong advanced, innovative tayo, alam nyo naman. Meron na tayong application on doing our biostatistics. Si ma'am, pinahirapan pa kami. Meron naman palang application. So, medyo complex din, medyo complicated lang ang ating application. Gagamitin nyo siya kapag nasa study proper na kayo. Pero, ito, mano-mano muna tayo. Ito siya. EpiInfo ang tawag dito. And then, yung p-value mo, titignan mo lang, p-value is equals to 0.01. Eh, yung alpha mo, 0.05. The p-value is less than your alpha. We therefore reject our HO. And then, lastly, we have to come up with the conclusion. If the decision is to reject the HO, restate mo lang yung HA mo. And then, dugtungan mo ng the sample statistic cannot support or is not consistent with your HO. And then, if the decision is not to reject HO, conclude that there is insufficient evidence to insert mo lang yung alternative hypothesis mo. So, in a nutshell, mag-uumpisa talaga tayo sa hypothesis testing kapag ka nagkanda ka ng study mo. And then, matatapos ka sa conclusion. Meron ka lang madaming computation dito, so medyo tedious work talaga to, pero kayang-kaya. And that concludes our discussion for the day. I'll leave a quote that says, "Failure is not a permanent experience. You must rise above it and choose to be better than you were a moment ago. Changing and growing is what makes you win." Again, if you have questions and clarifications, do not hesitate to PM me. Thank you and God bless.